Folks, it's the glorious return of Mega CD Monday. It's alliterative again. Good news.
Finally!
Alright, so it's been a while since we've done one of these Sega CD streams.
It's been a while.
There's a reason for that. Last week, I decided, after several requests, that we try to put together one of our other Mega CD systems. Let me tell you how that went.
Mm-hmm.
So this system that we've been using, it has problems, crashes, horrific glitches, visions of nightmares. So some people have suggested it was cursed and maybe it was time to put it out to pasture.
Fair enough.
I agreed. So I dug into the closet, hooked up Alex's Sega CD, tried attaching it to three different Genesis systems, wouldn't power on, completely dead. So I thought, okay, now it's time to bust out the big boys, the final option. Pulled out my Sega CDX, it powered on, I checked the hookups, established it into our entertainment center, fully integrated it, and then it didn't power on ever again. So we're back to our original system, full of the original glitches and nightmares. But here's one thing it can do. This is a region switch system, so it can still play Japanese Mega CD games. I've noticed it's been choking on FMV games in particular. Good news, Japan does not like FMV games, so most of these games we're going to play today should play fine, assuming they boot at all.
Ooh.
And hopefully we can get through the final dozen, because believe it or not, we're almost through the entire Mega CD lineup. We're in 1994. Only a scant dozen games are set to be released for this thing before Sega calls it quits and releases the Saturn. And we're going to start things off with a game called Ishi Hisaichi no Daisekai. That's the name.
Cool. What's this one about?
I don't know. Ishi Hisaichi himself is a manga artist.
Uh-huh.
I believe this is a strategy game featuring his various manga characters.
I did want to thank Ashiro for subscribing 13 months in a row. Thank you. They say, hey, I've been paying you guys to be weird for a whole year. Nice. Keep
cool,
being weird,
friends.
Thank you. We do appreciate your weird box.
And look at that. It booted first try.
Oh, I don't know. I hope this is normal.
It'll be fine.
You sure?
Yeah.
Okay.
Yeah, the Sega CD knows that soon it's going to be taken to a farm outside the city to live out the rest of its days.
Thank you to Bad Idea, who's been paying us for 4 months to be weird. Thank you very much.
Nice.
And Hulex Fox, also paying us 4 months to be weird. Hulex appreciates all of us, our NBs, our guys, and our gals. And Teeter resubscribes 5 months, thank you, and says, Danny, please close the CD door.
The CD door is closed.
It is closed. Also, thank you to Krungling for resubscribing 17 months. Thank you.
Nice.
So,
thank you all. Much appreciated. And the Sega CD is repaying you for your kindness with a black screen.
It is.
No, it's, this is minute one of the stream. You can't throw up a bouncers already. Yeah, the system's kind of flaky. It will read discs. One of the games I tested out the other night took 5 tries to load.
Cool.
So, let's get to resetting.
It's gonna be a wild one. Get your clip.
We only got a few games to go. We can do this. We can definitely do this.
Get your clip finger ready, because this is gonna be a wild one.
That's my clipping finger.
It is a CD2, and we have tried 3 different systems. Oh my god!
Okay, it
looks good. God! Okay!
The first frame of that video. Good. I do have plans in case the thing craps out entirely, so
yeah.
We will have a stream today. By hook or by crook?
Probably by crook.
Alright, so here's what we're gonna do. We're gonna boot this game again, and then I'm gonna mash that start button to get past this screen. Oh, I missed you, Sega CD Monday. I missed you so much.
This is going to be a fucking disaster.
This game takes up a total amount of 58 seconds on a Sega CD disc.
Not fast enough.
I tried. I wasn't quick enough.
We tried. We got more of it this time.
Yeah, that's frame 2.
Okay, we got it. Okay, we can do this. Oh, 5 frames? Okay, I think we can get up to 10.
We're taking you back to January 28th, 1994. your Mega CD system is about to be outmoded by the Sega Saturn, but they still have a few games to play. Can you not skip? Okay, I think the problem is you can't skip this video. So thank you, Sega. Thank you for putting in an unskippable intro animation that causes the game to crap out. I'm blaming Sega for this one.
We're getting suggestions for Turbo CD Tuesdays and Magnavox Mondays.
Ooh, Magnavox Mondays.
I have to do Shareware Mondays, I swear to God.
Seriously, the ISO for this is 6 megabytes, I think? So maybe the game just has the system has a problem reading such a small game.
It wants a big beefy meal of a game.
Yeah, where's that 670 megabyte BenQ it craves? Not some measly 2 megabyte ISO. That's barely a snack. It's like getting a kid's meal when you want an Admiral's platter. Because this is Retro Pals and this is Red Lobster.
Danny, what the fuck?
This is what, attempt number 4?
You wanna go to Red Lobster?
Maybe.
You know they have Crab Fest right now.
Crab Fest?
Yeah. Get your crabs. That's what's going on. All the games are crab. The Sega CD is already at Crab Fest.
It's got crabs? Oh, man. Alright, I'm going to give this one more try, and then we're going to move on to tonight's second game.
Sorry. Hey, Danny. You're a Red Lobster Daddy, says Submall.
I'd rather be a Red Lobster Daddy than a CBD Daddy.
Yeah.
Oh, man!
Oh,
so
man!
Close.
It almost rotated!
So close. You can hear the logo lasering into place if you listen to the sound, but it doesn't quite make it.
Oh my god.
So, Ichi Hisaichi is being a little bit shy, so let's move on to our second game. Shin Megami Tensei.
Will this work? Will the game about literally curses in a computer curse our system?
Yeah, a game about summoning demons. If it crashes, I'm sure nothing can go wrong. There was that legend in the Super Famicom version where if you loaded it like 1 out of 1,000 times, it would throw up a warning screen that says, shut it off, shut it off, shut it off.
Cool. So that's how to go good.
Uh-huh.
Yeah, maybe that's it. Maybe this will curse the Sega CD back to working.
That's what I'm hoping. Sims.
Egg.
They're an egg. Alright, so it's now February 25th, 1994. One of the final dozen releases for the Mega CD is a Sims-ported version of Shin Megami Tensei.
Cool colors.
Does that say Superman? Sadomasochism?
It's...
Pretty sure that's what it said.
Tokyo. Yeah.
Now this one, I don't think has been translated. If you want to play Shin Megami Tensei games, good news. As of a few weeks ago, all the Super Famicom versions are patched into English by fan translators. That was cool.
That was funny.
Did you see that? Yeah, they started to type in Atlas, but they backspaced. Atlas, consider yourselves deleted.
It says games about using a computer to summon demons, right?
Something like that. I've never played the originals. I've only played Persona 3 and 4. I'm a normie, sorry. I only like these games if you add extra anime and dating sim elements.
Mm-hmm. And like... production music.
Alright, this game aims to answer the question, who is the better girl, Yukari or Mitsuru?
Damn.
It's clearly Mitsuru.
Be good.
3D mode.
We're getting a suggestion for Zavix Port Zunday.
I do have most of the Zavix games
yes,
now.
Yes, he does. He's been...
They're taking up a lot of room.
They really are. We're
Each game comes with a massive peripheral.
We've been clearing out a lot of the crap we have here, and more crap gets cleared out, and then in comes Zavix. In comes Zavix.
I need an entire room dedicated to my Zavix collection.
You actually do. Zavix and fucking Skate.
Zavix and Sega Pico games.
Oh god, those things are so huge!
Y'all haven't lived till you've seen a Japanese Pico box. Puts the Neo Geo to shame. Welcome here. How good it is you have come, I assume is what it's saying. My name is... That's cool.
I love the little bounce there.
Performance here seems to be a little slow, but that's the Mega CD, not... Or rather, that's the game, not our Mega CD console.
I was gonna say, are you sure it's not the Mega CD?
Un? What's un?
All I can think of is underwear. Please help me.
See, I assume is like speed.
Mm-hmm.
Taiyoku is like what? Spells or something? But what's un?
Yeah, it is kind of weird how so many Western gamers are named
Alright, so if you're unfamiliar, this is a first-person dungeon crawler, completely unlike any other game we've seen on Mega CD. I'm just kidding, we played several of them.
Cool wall hole.
There was Might and Magic, there was,
It's Jesus!
Jesus. There he is.
Ah, sensual Jesus.
Your own sensual Jesus.
Hey, are you looking at sensual Jesus? Stop that!
Yeah, I think he's cool too. What's Jesus' name? Well, Jesus' name is Kaka.
Danny!
That wasn't intentional, it was just the first letter I saw. I assume it's asking me to name something else. Oh, it's another character. So we're doing character building, a la Wizardry.
Mm-hmm.
Boy, I tell you what, Japanese gamers love Wizardry. I was playing the Sega Ages port of Phantasy Star, and I was just thinking, oh, this is Wizardry. Like, I played Phantasy Star years ago and it didn't set in, but god, that game loves Wizardry so much.
There's the screen here.
Well, we've taken Jesus off his cross, and good news, he's buff.
Wow, Jesus got pecs.
And he's apparently some kind of android. Are we gonna get all six characters right now?
Just find another wall hole to creep through.
Hey!
Oh no, a goblin killed Jesus!
You goblin, get away from there!
Oh, look at that friendly face.
Oh, I can't stay mad at you.
Uh-uh.
Wanna join our party? This is Kiki.
Aw, Kiki. The Kiki Kakai?
Yeah, sure.
Kiki Kaka.
So if you're unfamiliar with the show, we try to show off at least a few minutes of gameplay from these games. A lot of them are dungeon crawlers, RPGs, freaking adventure games, so we're not going to get far in them. But I do want to show off at least what they're all about. Kiki just said Kuso to me.
Damn.
I'm going to kick him out of the party.
No! We need that we need that goblin with the friendly face. It's very reassuring. Oh. hold on. Let me...
Oh, it's fine.
Okay.
I guess we took a wrong turn.
She's like,
Sorry,
hey,
lady.
Get out of the bathroom.
Oh, it's just sheer coincidence I ended up in the women's bathhouse. And our adventure begins?
You're home.
Ah, oh, cool. Mom's telling me to get up, telling me to stay off the computer. It's 199X. Our name is Steven. It's .net.
So you're like on CompuServe or something?
Oh yeah, Japanese CompuServe.
Yeah, I guess this is circus music.
It sounds a little bit like it, yeah. I've logged on to DDS.net. Oh, never mind.
Oh, I guess Steven is sending you emails. You're not Steven.
Oh, okay. He's telling me how to talk. Oh, it's just like asking about things. It's
hey, mom. summoning demons on Prodigy.
A patrol car was here. Uh-oh, the cops are coming. I have a $10,000 debt with the mob.
What?
Better go to the cafe. Get a coffee.
That's what it is with you teens.
My Japanese is perfect. That's exactly what that meant.
Bad idea. The blue bar is supposed to, in 60 frames per second, it is flickering really, really fast to give it a vaguely transparent appearance.
Oh, it may not appear properly unless you're at 60 FPS.
Yeah.
Let's head on out.
Can you summon demons at the cafe?
I hope so. Oh, yeah. Clinic. Arcade. You know, I think it said something about the arcade.
Okay,
so let's go there. Whoops.
You like
great at games. You can't use your computer at the arcade.
Oh, and apparently at one point we had a dream.
Oh, I see. That's what that was about. Mom, I saw Jesus in my dream. I'm really bad at this. I've never played a Shin Megami Tensei game before.
According to Clipper Frog, you are meeting the Law Hero and the Chaos Hero.
Ooh.
I do like the Chaos Goblin. Is this the arcade?
Yeah.
This arcade is kinda... Where are the games?
Man. Oh, shit!
Uh-oh. Can you summon Jesus? As like a human shield?
Okay, let me, this is what this guy's saying. Is what he said.
Oh, it's a shopping arcade? Bullshit. It should be a game arcade, I'm sorry.
Well, it turns out he was a dang goblin.
Wait a minute! Oh no, that was his hand.
Yeah, I thought it was something else too.
Oh, goddamn.
Got an attack knife. Cool. Nothing here. Suppose we have to equip that. Yeah. That's my attacking knife.
I'm good.
Drugstore.
Can we get drugs?
Let's see what they got.
These drugs are so expensive. Like, no, they're not.
Drink is 4,000 yen.
That is expensive, but maybe it's like one of those huge, protein powder things.
We gotta save up for that.
Yeah.
So, interestingly, this game does use the Sega CD's built-in scaling capabilities for the mazes. That's not always the case for these maze games, we found.
Ooh, that looks like a cafe.
Antique store.
Oh, it's antiques.
No, same results either way. I want to meet some demons.
I know! Where are they? Maybe you need to go to the cafe. Maybe the demons are all, like, hanging out there.
Maybe I should play this in English sometime.
Maybe. Oh shit, cops are here.
Yeah, they've set up roadblocks. I guess they've quarantined the area.
But why?
Can't go in here either.
Oh, the cafe is in the shopping arcade.
Thought it was.
Okay, that was my bad. Confusing that. I see there's four entrances here, too.
Yeah. Now, where is this cafe? Survival?
Oh, it's a surplus store!
Call it a survival shop. Oh yeah, he says sell stuff like headgear. And laser boots. Not the first game I've seen laser boots in. I think that was a Phantasy Star thing, actually.
Okay, got some more plot info here. Hold on, before I get to that, I want to look at this cool gang.
They kicked me out.
You got an email from Steven when you wake up. It was an email forwarded to everyone on the DDS net. Basically, there's demons going to come to life in the world, and he created a devil summoning program. You download it on your ARMCOM, so...
I'm at the cafe.
Oh, nice.
The waitress said welcome.
That guy looks cool.
I'm gonna hit the bathroom. Oh wait, this is a bar.
Is that a coffee bar?
Yeah.
Cool. Starbucks. Give me one of those mango dragon fruit refreshers. Those are really good. Starbucks, sponsor me. Multiple people are saying you need to buy coffee beans here for your mom.
Is that what she wanted? Alright, let's go do that.
Also, we witnessed a murder at some point, I guess.
Oh, I kind of...
Well, we just kind of blazed through that. We need coffee beans.
Coffee beans. Alright. Yes.
So the guy who turned into a demon slashed him in the throat with a knife, and then you took that knife, so... Great job! We're gonna be framed for murder, Dan.
Oh, maybe that wasn't a good idea.
Oh, we needed the knife.
Well, he's not letting me do anything, so maybe I have the beans.
No, let's see.
Maybe I'm just full of beans.
Mm-hmm.
I'm gonna head back home to Mom. If we haven't made any progress, I'll have to move on. But, hey, it's a game that worked!
Yeah, hey! Not cursed today.
No curses whatsoever, except for that one game that wouldn't boot.
Oh, that's fine. It probably wasn't worth it.
Alright, Mom, got your beans.
That's your dog, Pascal, I think.
Yeah, his name's Pascal.
Chat says, we stan. So.
He says, bow. Wow. Bow wow.
Okay, so in the original version of this game, the dude didn't drop the knife, so that's new to the Sega CD version.
Oh, okay.
I need to play this sometime.
This looks like it could be really cool. They did make a whole bunch of these, so I assume that they're pretty darn good. Ugh, I'm not making any progress. I think I'll have to move on.
Ah, damn.
Still, this is a game for Sega CD, only in Japan. Maybe someday people will translate it, but there's probably not much need since it's in English already on Super Famicom.
Mm-hmm.
Mom mad at me for using the computer instead of picking up her precious coffee beans.
If you go to sleep, it advances the game, but do you really wanna?
How to sleep?
I assume you just go to your bed and choose, like, nap time.
Yeah. Let's try that.
Okay. Mom's like, could I please get my beans? And you're like, I'm sorry.
Oh, let's save. Oyasumi. Alright, we're asleep. Now to enter the dream world. And there's more naked men here. What does it mean?
No idea.
Friends Kaka and Kiki are here.
Oh, good.
Oh, and now I get to navigate the maze myself. Okay. So we do get a little bit of a glimpse of the gameplay, at least. Where's Teddy? Is there any kind of animal that's trapped inside a larger mascot costume?
Looks like the lady from the cafe.
Oh, yeah.
Murphy Brown is here.
I don't have any MP. I must be a barbarian.
Mm. Still don't like these wall holes.
They're totally normal.
See
this? Also totally normal. You! Were you looking at my naked people orgy?
No! We're normal! Please put some underwear on.
Man, this is weird. I will say this stands out compared to the other first-person dungeon crawlers we played.
Oh, that lady was being sacrificed, so good job. You saved her. Or you did something.
Gonna put it all into strength.
Everyone's saying this is too normal.
Too normal for us.
I mean, Naked People Orgy is pretty normal for retro pals.
Oh yeah, what's the other kind of orgy other than the Naked People Orgy? Steven's emailing me again, and much like Persona, I can only assume this series also takes forever to get started. But Shin Megami Tensei, it is a very long series that you can get into if you have the time and patience. Me, I just want to go to the circus. The F1 circus.
Oh shit. Do 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 do.
Y'all ever been to the F1 circus? They got those formula cars that are just full of clowns.
The clowns go extremely fucking fast and then mm-hmm. they stop and then like 20 of them come out.
F1 circus Chadley.
Oh my god. Take that down.
I hope Circus Charlie's in this. So this is the only Mega CD game made by Nichibutsu, who are very well-versed in the F1 games. It's telling me I don't have enough save data.
Well, too bad. We'll move on. No worries. You don't want to save. Saving is for suckers.
Yeah. We've joined the Nichibutsu Racing League.
I like this music.
This is racing game music, I suppose. Now, they made several of these on Super Famicom, at least one on Genesis, or Mega Drive, rather.
This music.
And this is everyone's favorite kind of racer, the Japanese top-down racer.
Oh, boy.
They made so many of these in Japan, dude. Barely any of them came out here in the States, because, well, at least in my experience, they're kind of awful. I don't like them at all.
This is not an F1 Mahjong game, unfortunately.
Yeah, it's an F1 circus. Here we are at the big top. Barnum and Bailey present cars.
Well, they had to do something once they stopped using animals, I guess. Actually, no, it's Ringling Brothers. No, Ringling Brothers and Barnum and Bailey were the same thing, weren't they?
What about Wrestle Circus? Oh wait, they're dead now.
They're so dead! Oh my god, they're beyond dead, dude!
As of this week, Wrestle Circus is no more, I'm sorry to say.
What sucks is they canceled their show after everyone had already made flight plans and was already in Texas, so...
Ooh.
Yeah, one dude got stranded in New Jersey because of this. Ooh. And another, yeah, a bunch of local orgs,
Don't do that! Don't piss off wrestlers! You can piss off any other kind of people, but don't piss off wrestlers.
They're very strong.
My name's Billy, and I have dreams of becoming a race car driver.
Let's see. Sex wrestler, blood wrestler, nationality, wrestling.
I was born in 1912.
You're so old, I love you.
On the 77th month... Oh, it won't let me do that. On Halloween 1912, I was born. And I hail from the great land of... Finland.
Y'all met Jervis Cottonbelly Uzi? I've seen that guy like twice. That's amazing.
And because this is a Japanese game, you have to enter your blood type.
Oh, you're universal, I see.
Mm-hmm.
Oh.
Oh, you can make your own dude! Look at this!
Yes! Oh, character creation! Oh,
oh
my god!
Oh, you can make a real fat dude!
I love him! He's good!
Let's give him the nerdiest hairstyle possible. Yeah, look at this. Alright, well, this is a good feature. I enjoy this. Let's give him really tiny eyes.
No, that's good. I love them.
Oh, me. Yes!
That's just me.
Okay, that mouth was made for this face type, so mm-hmm. I have to go for this.
I love Billy.
Billy, the 100-year-old Finnish race car driver.
If anyone makes fun of Billy, don't.
Hey, Billy has won 100 championships for his 100 years.
Billy is so much better than me, honestly. Well, according to Electric Boogaloo, F1 Circus CD was developed by Cream, a portmanteau of creative amusement.
That's a pretty good portmanteau. All right, Officer...
I love him!
Officer Jack Nicholson / Ronald Reagan is here to tell us F1 is too severe with newcomer.
It is.
I can't introduce you to anybody. It's bilingual! Why is it bilingual? I mean, I appreciate it. It's like they knew we would stream it.
Honestly, I appreciate them supporting us streaming this.
Boy, some really limited use of color in this game. Mega CD could be more colorful than this. I'm just sitting here in my car thinking about my options. Let's start the engine.
Is that just engine starting noises?
Maybe.
Wow.
Yep, car sounds good. Sounds like a car.
It's car.
Oh, it's Super Monaco GP. It looks exactly like it. Wee, I'm a big boy. where's the go button? Oh, I probably have to shift into gear, huh? There we go. Well, look what turned me into a liar. This is not a top-down racing game. This is a Super Monaco GP clone. I'm very surprised because they did make other F1 Circus games that were top-down racers, as far as I know.
According to Electric Boogaloo, the one for Mega Drive was actually done by our pals at Micronics.
So. Ooh, maybe that was the one I was thinking of. Okay.
Yeah, what is this percussion?
I like it.
Oh, wait. Oh shit, it's getting good.
Dude, look how hard he's turning the steering wheel. I saw a GIF today of a first-person F1 car of what happened when their front tires just popped off.
What happens? Is it fucked up?
He started steering like crazy, like this guy did, and he managed to survive it.
Holy shit! Shout out to F1 drivers!
He just kind of grazed off a wall. Still
wow.
Is. It's kind of scary. I like the drum and bass soundtrack, by which I mean it uses a drum and bass.
Oh, we're having the debate over GIF versus GIF. I'm sorry, but the correct answer is GIF. That's how you pronounce it.
Choosy moms choose GIF.
It's true.
Okay, I think that's a good lap. Let's go to the actual race.
Oh, Danny, you retired.
I retired at 100 years old. Wait, I don't want... Oh, I see. You have to actually wait before the race can start.
Are you kidding me?
In the meantime, you can take a practice lap.
Oh.
Wow, this is a realistic simulation of a race car driver. Apparently you spend a lot of time waiting. Well, it does seem to be accelerated time, at least, because it started at 15 and now it's at 7:30. Ooh, different track. So, let's take another lap while we wait for the race officials to get their shit together. A dude rammed into me from behind, did you see that?
Mm-hmm, now he's on fire.
Yeah, he was smoking in the rear view.
Cool. Well, he shouldn't try to kill you. I like the music in this game.
It's kind of minimalist, but it's okay. So I don't blame them for trying to rip off Super Monaco GP, because that game was pretty popular here on Sega Genesis. I think it was the first Genesis game to get a 10 in EGM. A 10 for a racing game. Mario's not even in it.
Does this feel like a 10 to you?
Well, this game feels more like a 6.
Mm.
But maybe once there's actual racers to compete with, it'll be different.
All right, Abby mentions that circus is the Latin word for a racetrack.
Oh.
Circus Maximus.
See, here we call it a circuit.
That's true.
Because a circus is a place where clowns and elephants are. Let's put in. Give the boys something to do. I'm pitting in. I'm pitting in as hard as I can.
It's doing good. You're just ruining the grass.
Well, in the setup time, I managed to retire twice. Oh, here we go. Countdown.
9, 38.
Look at my machine. It's a cool machine. It is a colony.
Nice.
Good. I'm doing it. Oh wait, I could probably just exit out of here and start up the thing, but where's the tension in that? It's all about waiting for that timer to count down. 10 seconds to go. It's showtime.
Here we go.
You ready to be a race car driver?
No. Are you? I've never done this before.
Oh, it just set me on exit. I could have done that all along. It's my first day. Come on.
Well, we'll do it.
Nobody told me what to do, so I just sat in my car the entire race. Wait, what? Did I miss the race? Was I just sitting in my car listening to the radio?
Yeah! Now I have to do 15 more minutes! Danny!
Wait a minute. No! Alright, let's do a freaking exhibition race because I can't figure out how to enroll in F1. Oh, man. All the teams are laughing at me. They're like, look at that Joker just listening to the radio in his car.
It's like, oh, this is so good. They're real good beats to study race to.
The Tokyo GP. Let us start. Alright, here we go. Time for action. Do we want cigar shape, wedge shape, turbo car, 90s type, or wing car?
90s type.
Yeah.
90s
That's
type.
That's us. We're the 90s type.
Mm-hmm.
Oh, you have to hit A to overtake.
Oh.
Well, guess what just showed up at our door?
No way.
I saw the mailman put a package on our doorstep. That is our new Sega CD.
Should I get it?
Why don't you go get it?
Okay.
I'll hold down the race here.
Okay, you race.
The Sega CD won't be put into action today, but
a
very generous supporter of the show offered their working Sega CD unit.
We should also probably take it out of the boiling heat.
Yeah, that too.
I don't want our child to suffer.
All right, so we're finally racing. After many preliminaries, after sitting in the pit for 8 hours, and then everyone laughing at me, we've finally been allowed onto the racetrack. And you know what? This game is not very good. It's no Super Monaco GP, I can tell you that much. How's it looking?
Danny, it's here.
Oh, he shipped it in.
Baby.
He shipped it in a Sega Genesis arcade power stick box. That's cool. Alex is cradling
Angel.
It like a baby.
Angel. Oh, it's beautiful. Oh.
This is courtesy of friend of the show, The Ultimo.
The Ultimo.
Who the second they heard that our Sega CD was dying, they were like, I got one. I'll send it to you right now.
And we resisted for a while, being like, no, we're good. But we were not good.
Yeah,
we
after I tested good. The other units, I decided, you know what, might as well.
Should we do an unboxing? Shit, we could do an unboxing on air right now if you wanted.
Yeah, that's too much work.
Yeah, we're lazy, sorry.
Plus, setting it up involves swapping out AC adapters, which is more work than I want to put into the stream right now.
Boo, yeah. Alright, let me put the child down.
Here's what I miss about Super Monaco GP. There was stuff on the side of the road you could crash into, and your car would explode. There's not anything like that in this game, though. I don't think you can explode.
You want to see the un... Everyone wants to see an unboxing.
I don't know. There might be stream inappropriate stuff in there.
I doubt it.
Oh, I got in third position. All right, here we go. The full race. The actual thing. The full-ass circus is going to unfold right in front of our eyes.
All right, I'm ready for some Cirque.
The old Cirque du Soleil.
Thank you, Hexagon Witch, for the resub. They say, can't explode? 0 out of 10.
Yeah, I agree. Thank you. I see. So you have an overtake meter, which lets you mini-turbo to go past your opponents. It looks like it eats up your fuel if you do that. There was an arcade game we played on Sega System 32 that had the exact same mechanic. I don't remember which one that was, though.
Where'd you go? What are those buildings back there? I guess like an office park or something.
It's with those odd little graphical glitches.
It's normal, it's fine. Don't think about it.
Okay.
Don't think about how they're kind of increasing.
Pretty lame, Nichibutsu.
Oh, it's fine.
Would you pay $50 for this?
¥5,800? Fuck. No. I'm sorry.
I was looking at ads for Mega CD games today, and Mansion of Hidden Souls was ¥5,800. Night Trap, advertised on the same page, ¥6,800. Night Trap is a premium experience compared to Mansion of Hidden Souls. Oh, did I use up all my overtake juice? I think I have.
Danny, no.
Now I can't overtake anyone.
You need that juice.
I used it all up. Well, at the very least, I can say this isn't a top-down racing game. However, it's still a racing game.
Oh, shit.
I didn't pit in.
The music woke the fuck up.
Did it?
Yeah, I went bong.
Wake up, it's time to go bong. You know what? I don't think I'm going to be finishing this one.
You sure?
There's a few games I want to go through the effort of playing all the way through, and this is not one of them. But at least now we know what it looks like. This is a game that was released in the final year of the Mega CD's lifespan in Japan.
That car was glitching in and out, but I guess it's still on the track.
Yeah, the draw distance is kind of weird, because you can see the cars jumping around if you can't see the turn yet. That just makes it look odd. Nichibutsu, you can do better than this. Next time, pretend this is one of your nudie Mahjong games.
Danny!
That's where they make all their money. Maybe make a nudie F1 car game.
I would love that! No.
It's the exact same, only the cars are just driven by naked women.
Yeah, and then, you get to see a naked woman when you finish, and that's it. It's not, even sexual. She's just like, God, I wish they would let me
overtook.
Wear a helmet. You did it!
I overtook right off the road.
Yeah, you're still ahead, though, right?
I feel obligated to at least finish this race, so okay. Let's do it. We're on lap 2, about to enter lap 3. This shouldn't be too much longer. And hey, I'm in first place. They call me King of the Circus. Hey!
Wake up!
Don't you overtake me.
So you're driving right to the city?
Mm-hmm. Just gonna drive right off the course.
Like, listen, I gotta get to downtown stat.
I got hungry. I saw a sign that said the McRib was back. They have McRib in Japan?
That is such a good question. Chat, I'm crowdsourcing you.
How many of y'all have had a McRib in Japan?
Do they have McRibs in other countries?
Maybe they have their own seasonal thing, like the McHot Dog.
Oh, that's awful.
Or the McSushi.
I'm hearing yes. About McRib in Japan.
Oh, really? Cool.
Yes. Oh my god. 2 people say yes.
Good.
Oh my god. Oh my god.
I'm glad. All the worlds should have access to school cafeteria barbecue burger.
That's what it is, right?
Yeah, like, it's literally just barbecue patties. It's really nostalgic, actually. That's why I like eating them.
Yeah,
it's like I'm back in fifth grade.
In the UK, they did used to have it in the UK.
Used to?
Yeah.
Did they get banned?
I'm assuming they didn't get banned. I assume it just, they were like, I don't know, they were like, no one's eating these McRibs, it's not worth it.
Oh, we're too good for McRib.
Do you blame them?
I'm not too good for McRib.
Is a McLobster any good? That's like on the East Coast and in Canada.
Order me up one of those McFogwa.
They did not Brexit the McRib. That's not part of being in
Is that what caused all that? God damn it, McDonald's. Well, we're in first place. We're about to cross the finish line. Yeah, finished.
The queen herself declared the McRib illegal. She had a bite of it and she's like, oh, this is just dreadful. Absolutely not.
Didn't realize how lucky we were to be in a society where the McRib is free. All right, and here's our reward. A screen that says try again. I'm gonna go with no.
Seb Mall had the McPizza from the big Orlando McDonald's, their take. He says it wasn't great.
Yeah, I had the McHot Dog once. That was actually a thing for a very short time.
I remember the McHot Dog.
It was also not great. Well, that's my story.
That's a good story, Dan.
You know who else has a story to tell?
Hmm.
Oda Nobunaga.
Nobunaga back again.
Well, he has an ambition. An ambition to invade the Sega CD with Nobunaga no Yabo, the final Koei Games release for Mega CD. Now, we've seen Winning Post. We've seen Genghis Khan. We saw at least two other strategy games. And their final one is their big flagship series. Nobunaga.
Oh, they have McCurry at a London McDonald's? Or they used to. I am... shocked.
Are you?
No, but I can't imagine it being good.
Play this. Yep, get ready for another fully Japanese game. Oh, the Ultimo's here. We got your package.
Oh, yes. Yeah, I saw them early being like, ah, no, thank you. Your baby is here just fine. I cradled it and gave it a hug.
471 blocks, you say? I don't think so.
Hey, we're out. Hey, 00 for past the... Arnold, remember, we're past the logo.
Yeah, we made it.
Yeah.
This is one of them Ko Shibusawa productions. Man loves his strategy.
Mm-hmm. Oh, God.
Here come the horses.
Horses are just... This car won't start.
Get the crank. I gotta start up this horse. Where do I stick it?
Danny.
Sorry.
Blombie horse?
This is a Blombie horse. And then the horse is all burned up.
Aw, rip.
Yeah, we're not going to spend much time with this, because we haven't spent much time with the other Koei games, but this is their big one. They brought it to Mega CD, never let it out of Japan, even though several other console ports of this game did make it to the States. And there's the man himself. Him and his famous gun? Wow, no wonder he took over Japan. He was the only guy with a gun.
He fucking just shoots people.
Yeah, let's do it. I'm gonna skip ahead to 1583. The first month, please.
Also, do you want to apologize for the frame rate issues? Not sure what's happening, but...
No, we are getting some drop frames.
Yeah.
Damn.
It was fine on Friday is the thing.
Yeah.
Friday was perfect.
It's always random when that happens.
Mm-hmm. I don't know if it's our ISP or Twitch or our cursed Sega CD getting its revenge. It's going out into the night with vengeance.
There.
Danny!
We're Emperor Pooh. Come on.
That's fine. That's whatever.
I'm just agreeing to sign over my rights to everything. Just going, yes, yes, yes.
Love this music.
It's Nobunaga's theme song. Yep, damn Time Warner Charter Spectrum.
Whatever they call it now. I can't wait for all the companies to merge. And then they all offer you like 1 megabyte per $50.
Oh, there it goes again.
That's back. I'm doing this all day. That's it, you're right, ZeroServe. We aren't logged into our Bethesda Net account. That's why.
That's what happened. I love that they were like, oh no, it was supposed to be optional, even though the text clearly says it's required. No, it's totally a mistake that we wanted your personal information for playing this old game. Why would we ever do that?
No, we would never.
All right, well, that was a basic history of Japanese unification. You get all that?
Yeah, they were fighting, and then they fought until they turned into one big nation. There was a battle in the middle of Japan, and they had a big fight, and then they all tweeted about it, and they all subtweeted about it. And
that dude bring his kid? Come on, dude. Get a babysitter. Trying to unite Japan here. Baby Naga.
Like Gaga Goo Goo gonna unite this nation.
Uh-oh.
Oh shit, the baby has lightning powers!
Didn't see that coming.
Don't mess with that baby. Do not mess with that baby.
Sir, the baby has replaced Western Japan with a picture of a dude's face.
Oh no, there's a dude's face in the middle of the sea. Eastern Japan too suffers this fate. Oh, hot damn, it's all like a case of sores or something.
These people are very insulted that you refer to them as sores.
No, that's not cool. That's not cool.
Don't you know who these people are?
I was gonna say, well, I know, but Nobunaga's just, you know, he's got a gun, so...
They're the five great mustached rulers of Japan.
Hectara says baby no in going to war. Are they gonna cancel Nobunaga? Finally. That guy's been talking too much shit.
See, we wouldn't have, like, 57 different territories if Baby Joe was in charge.
Would we just be like, would the United States just be like one massive state?
Mm-hmm. There wouldn't be no 57 stations of the Tokaido. It would just be one, like it should be. And then...
Electric Boogaloo Close, you're thinking of Baby Joe... Yeah! Baby Jobunaga, thank
Baby
you.
Baby Jobunaga. Now that's a crossover I want to see.
You know, I can't stop you from calling Nobunaga a warlord daddy, but...
Yeah, that's pretty accurate. Alright, here's what we're gonna do. We're gonna enter a couple of menus. I'm gonna act like I know what I'm doing.
Mm-hmm, mm-hmm.
And then I'm gonna get frustrated and quit.
Cool.
Yeah, yeah. Till that ground. I'm a great emperor. Alright, now I want you to do this. Okay, my turn's over. No, I don't want to save. There we go. It's the other emperor's turn now.
It is being requested that you nuke Alaska.
I would if I could. We've declared war
Danny,
on Alaska.
Danny, don't say that on stream!
That's in reference to Third World War, a game we played a few weeks ago.
We have no desire to nuke anything.
Especially Alaska.
God, that's so complicated.
Those poor polar bears.
They didn't deserve it.
Hey, guess what? This is another Koei simulation game. It's very in-depth, very fascinating
Poo-poo.
If you're into this kind of thing. However, if you're gonna play through it, you probably shouldn't play through it in Japanese. Unless you're fluent in Japanese, specifically wartime kanji.
Danny's ambition, nuke Alaska. Thank you. Thank you, Uzi.
Alright, I'm getting on my horse and riding out of here. Good show.
Good show.
We did it. We escaped before the hordes came for us. It does say poo-poo.
It does. That's why I was like, haha, poo-poo.
Alright. Away from the Koei simulation games and into something we all can appreciate. Next up, Urusei Yatsura.
Oh, nice. Is it Dear My Friends?
Dear My Friends. Yes, that's what it was called.
Perfect.
Now this game here, you can tell that the Mega CD had a really limited lifespan because this game was announced before the system even came out. And it was time for released, by the time it was finished up, this turned out to be one of the final 10 releases. I love when that happens, when a launch game turns out to be one of the final games.
That always happened with Kirby.
It did, yeah. So you can think of this as the Kirby of the Mega CD.
Oh, this is a Game Arts joint, nice.
Yep, Game Arts, I think it's similar in structure to their previous game, Yumimi Mix, which was the lesbian horse game.
You've mentioned that before, and... Oh, I remember it now.
Yeah.
Oh, okay.
Same style, visual comic, colors optimized for the Mega CD, so it should actually look pretty good. Anyone know anything about this? Is it based on any of the episodes or the OVAs? Oh, now there's some color use for you.
Oh, that's nice.
Yeah, lesbian horses.
Mm-hmm.
Why did they let any other company other than Game Arts make Mega CD games? Like, they knew how. Look at this. This is beautiful.
This looks great.
Would you like to sign a survey?
Oh god, no. Please.
It's for Nintendo to de-censor the new Fire Emblem.
Alright, so this is apparently an original story.
Oh, okay. Book 'em horns. She's mad.
I was gonna say, no one in Japan gives a shit about the Texas Longhorns, but I know that can't be true.
Says you.
Shout out to the Longhorn stands out in Japan.
Taru would be uncensored vaginas. Yes.
God damn it, Danny.
He's on the internet constantly complaining about that kind of stuff.
I love you, and I love you so much, but I never want to hear you say the phrase vagina bones ever again.
No problem. No problem. Ooh, sexy. I want to point out, not FMV. This is all with the system's hardware horsepower.
That's why it's not freaking out.
Yeah.
Yes, I am censoring gamers all by myself.
Look at this. What other company could turn an anime opening into a Sega CD opening without using FMV? Or, you know, just pre-rendered video in general?
This is so good!
It looks so good.
It looks beautiful.
I think I ought to collect the Game Arts games for Mega CD. There's only like 3.
And they're good, too.
Yeah. Oh, there's more than that. There's the 2 Lunars.
Well, you already got one.
Yeah. I gotta get Yumimi Mix. And this. This is one of the more well-known Mega CD games. I should have this in my collection. How'd they load all these frames into the memory? The system's kind of a piece of crap.
I like the lady dressed up as a dog.
Yeah.
That's just...
So you recognize these characters?
Very, 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 very little. But yes, I've seen some of the show. I really like the second movie, Beautiful Dreamer, and I've played the really shitty games. So.
We played the Famicom one for Mascot Friday once.
Yeah.
That was cool.
I've read some of the comic.
There she is.
Makes her look like she's just got a giant head and then legs.
Yeah, I know.
Like, head legs.
Did you say Yatsura Dungeon Crawler for Game Boy Color? Or Game Boy, even.
Also, thank you, Ashro, for doing, for working on the new release of Beautiful Dreamer.
Oh, yeah. That's a pretty recent development.
Have you ever seen Beautiful Dreamer?
I have not.
You should see it. It's a weird, weird, weird movie.
Well, let's go down to the store and pick up the release from Discotech.
This episode is sponsored by Discotech. Also, it's free on Tubi TV if you want to see it that way.
Oh, yeah.
That's actually how I saw it recently. I was just like, oh shit, this really esoteric anime is free.
I love the way she flies out of the room.
I actually need to get that on Blu-ray.
This one's more of an adventure game. Yeah, Yumimi Mix was more of a digital comic where things kind of just progressed regardless, but I guess they give you some kind of input.
Yeah, I had Beautiful Dreamer on VHS back in the day, and I got it at a con from Central Park Media or whatever that group was. I got it for $5, and I watched it so much I literally wore it out, so when they were going under, they were selling their stuff for 99 cents, and I picked up another copy. And then I found a copy at a Goodwill. Actually, not a Goodwill, it's another store, so I've got that on, like, VHS twice.
It's not letting me eat the jacket.
That's messed up.
What else can we look at? Oh, there she is.
She's like, don't leave your room.
Ooh. Let's play some tunes.
Maybe you put a disc in.
Oh, power. Yeah, okay. Checked.
Oh, there's nothing inside!
I gotta find a disc. Mm. Alright, we've reached the first puzzle.
See multiple people compare this to Willy Beamish.
I greatly prefer this to Willy Beamish already, even though I can't understand anything. Fucking Willy Beamish.
Why do you have a poster of a lady yelling?
This is what I'm into, alright?
I love you, but you're weird.
I like being yelled at. Oh, it changes. Weird. Already burned myself.
Okay, I like that you can burn yourself.
Look at this. This is like a My Disney Kitchen or some shit.
I love this. Oh, I love games where you can make a dumb mess. Oh, that's so good.
What? Well, I'm just gonna leave the kettle on, leave the water running. Lum, you deal with this. It's fine.
So apparently every screen in this game has wonderful secrets you can find by clicking around.
Oh.
Beautiful.
Yeah, it seems they put more effort into this than Yumimi Mix.
Is there a toilet?
Oh, hello. The Lum Game Console! She's not letting me play it.
He's like, Mom said I could play this now. Nope. Well, they hate your ass because you're a real piece of shit.
That makes sense.
No, you actually are a real piece of shit in the show. Lum deserves better than you, and you deserve to get your ass kicked.
I want some of them tasty fish with the red bean paste inside. What are those called?
Oh, I love those back when I could eat what back before I realized I was celiac. Oh, those are so good. Those are delicious. I also just love that red bean paste.
Taiyaki, that's what it is.
Oh, those are so good.
He's just eating a whole basket full.
Oh yeah, I guess he is unlikable like Willy Beamish. Good point, Hitara.
That's one thing these games have in common.
Yes, I have heard the UK dub of Urusei Yatsura. It is wild.
Letter from his mom?
Mom probably gets him too.
So who's the little Lum?
I want to say that's Lum's child from the future, but I could be so wrong on that. Someone who's more...
Is that like the Chibi Usa of this game?
If someone who's actually knows more about the show knows, can describe that character, please do.
I'm watching soaps.
Mm-hmm. Oh, that's her cousin.
Oh, okay.
Ten. Okay, it's just a cousin.
Lum's telling us to go to school.
She's like, please go to school.
Yeah, we're having some frame drops here.
It's not just y'all.
Luckily, not much animation in this game. I got blown up. Oh, just a typical day. Grab this cat and be on our way. Hey, come back here.
Cat doesn't like you.
Nani? Lan-chan wa ouchi o hikkoshi shimashita. Basho wa Tomobiki 2-chome 43 banchi desu.
I really like the adventure game setup here. It lets you just cycle through the different actions by pushing B. Mm-hmm. A lot of other games made it way more complicated than it had to be.
Did you just ring your own doorbell? Stop it.
Ping pong. Let's get out of here. Nothing to see around here.
Let's go that way. We're just Cherry no tento rashiku cherry no mark ga tsuite iru na.
Cherry must be out. Also, who's Cherry?
I do not remember. Chat, who's Cherry?
Okay. Nothing to do. I guess we should go to school.
Oh, is Cherry the monk? Okay.
Oh, okay.
I'm sorry, but it looks like this map has sores.
Well, let's start exploring. Hey, I found my way.
Hey, you're at school.
うちとダーリンが通っているトムビキ高校だっちゃ。土曜日の午後だともう静かだっちゃね。
Just going to school with my alien pal Lum.
I think Lum is the only non-horny person in the series, honestly.
Look at her though.
Yeah, you'd think so, but she's also the only person who can stand Taru, I think.
こちら留守番電話です。ご用のある方。ダメだ、上がっちまうぜ。俺ってこういうの苦手なんだよな。なんでもう時間が来たのかよ。まあとりあえず伝言よろしく頼むぜ。
Sounds like the phone has anxiety.
Well, I feel you.
Oh, I wanted to keep ringing the bell.
なんで？ラムと諸星じゃねえか。ちょうどよかった。頼みてえことがあるんだけどよ。ランのやつがここに財布忘れちまったんだよな。俺、ランのうち知らねえし、まさか月曜日に渡すってわけにもいかねえだろ。
わかったよ、リュウちゃん。僕が必ずランちゃんの元に届けてあげるからね。
Yeah, yeah.
ちゃんとランのところに届けてくれよ、諸星。
Let's go to the arcade. 忘れ
るんじゃねえぞ。
よかった。出てきたのがリュウちゃんで、親父が出てきたらどうしようかと思ったわい。
Let's go to class.
All right. Danny, get yourself an education.
I'm ready to learn.
なんじゃお主ら、土曜の午後だというのにまだおったのか?
I think that's the nurse.
何? ちょっと失せ物を探しておってな。
さくらさん、探し物でしたら僕がお手伝いしますよ。
いや、
結構。A Sega education.
もう帰るところだったのでな。
Yeah, nervous. The character who we just met, not the nurse. Their gender is just like, eh?
They won't accept a coin purse.
Accepts ticket?
私の探しているものではないな。
A different reaction to it, at least.
Like, oh, the ticket.
Here we are. Here's the boys.
Megane tachi, mada nokotte ita no ka?
Megane tachi? That's like the guy in the glasses and his friends.
Nani yattenda megane?
Kimatte oro. Warewore ramu shinetai saikou kanbu kai kaigi o hiraite otta no yo.
Ai mo kawarazu kudaran koto yatteru na.
Kisama ni nani ga wakaru? Warewore no suukou naru ai, shijou no koufuku wa ramu-san atte koso, ramu-san ga ite koso, chijou wa eiga o kiyameru koto ga dekiru nda. Kisama no youna bonjin ni wa 一生わかるまいかな。
一生わかりたくもないわい。
I don't think he likes me. But will he like me if I gave him this?
そんなものはいらん。
I guess not. Mom, tell me what to do. Toilet. Let's go.Flush myself down the toilet.
Can do.
Oh, this is like Willy Beamish. A bully is gonna pop up and attempt to kill me. Whoa!
Try another door.
Okay.
Fightemos.
Just gonna pretend like I didn't see that.
Can you flush any of the toilets?
Oh, can wash your hands at least.
Well, that's good.
Tell him to put his hands all over these toilets and he's not doing anything.
Rude.
Maybe he can put his mouth on them.
Danny?
I don't think that's gonna work.
Okay.
Maybe the toilets will talk if they had a little incentive. Nah, I'm just being stupid.
Can he go? Oh, what's that?
That's finished, Kayo. Kitamen, amo.
Dude hates plungers.
Mad at the janitor supplies.
Man, I'm sad you can't flush a toilet. Game arts, get good.
Yeah. Fuck school. I'm going somewhere else.
Can you go to the arcade?
Let's find out. Oh, wait. That's just my house. Let's go here.
I'll go to your house. Okay.
I'm glad Game Arts made an actual adventure game and not just a digital comic. Oh! It's one of them yokai!
Cool.
I really like the animations that have no kind of bearing on anything. They're just there to be cool.
They just exist. Whoa, cool.
Okay.
God. That's what I call gentrification.
Let's go.
Yeah, I guess Game Arts did do Rise of the Dragon.
Oh, that's true. They technically did do one.
Mm-hmm.
That wasn't their original thing, though.
Yeah.
The door to the spaceship is locked.
Oh, shit.
I really like this game, though.
Yeah, I'd like to see a translation of this, although it seems like it'd be a pain in the fucking ass.
I'll do the dubbing. I volunteer. I'll do all the characters.
Even Lum?
Yeah, here's Ataru. Hey, Lum, what you doing? And here's Lum. Oh, darling. What do you think?
You know what? You know what? I support your dream.
Cool.
Can't say I'm unsupportive.
I don't think we're gonna make much progress without knowing what we're doing, but I think we got a good look at this game.
Mm-hmm.
I'd like to play some more of it. Maybe someone out there wants to translate it.
Think
get some actual voice actors, maybe. It would be a ton of work, but we'd play it. We totally would. Wow, I was ready to end the stream and we still have like 40 minutes left.
No, it's because we have plenty of time left.
Why don't we go into our next game that I was planning to save till next week? This one's even weirder.
Uh-oh.
This is called Bakuden Unbalanced Zone.
For reals?
Yeah.
People are demanding the unboxing. Okay, but that unboxing requires us setting up the lighting, and then setting up the table, and then setting up the webcam.
It's not doable, I'm sorry.
We're sorry. Like, we would literally
You will see what is in the package on the stream eventually.
We will show you.
Alright, it is now February 22nd, 1994, and the long-awaited release of Bakuden Unbalanced Zone is here.
Is it unbalanced or unbalanced?
Oh, I think it is just unbalanced.
Okay.
Now loading.
Come on.
You ready for this?
I'm ready to get unbalanced. Oh no, it's Sony!
Oh no.
Wow! Wow!
Bakuden.
The sounds. People saying, is this rock cappella?
The B-sharps, everybody!
This rules!
More games need more barbershop quartets.
Completely fucking agree. Unironically agree. Absolutely, yes.
I have no idea what this is.
Is this gonna be ska?
Sure looks like it. Those look like some ska guys to
me. Oh my god, I want my Sega CD ska game!
Developed by Kogaru Studio and also on PC Engine CD, according to Boogaloo. Bakufu Slump. Oh, look at that icon! Man, that's good.
Oh my god, this is great.
I'm just kind of headbanging over here.
Yeah, I was gonna say, I'm into this. I don't even know if I want to start the game. I like this.
See, this is why it's worth digging through the Japanese Mega CD library. It's nothing but dungeon crawlers, and then you get to this. There's no way the game itself can live up to that intro. So what are you thinking? Strategy game?
I couldn't even tell you what this would be.
Me either. This is new and exciting territory. It's a rock band! Yes! It's the Japanese Revolution X!
Thank you to Go Ducks Go for the 100 bits. Hopefully you enjoy this ska rock band game.
Thank you. Much appreciated.
Something? I'm looking these up on something that's not gonna... Okay, who the fuck are these slump boys? So why is the screen so small?
Oh no, here comes the Kool-Aid man. He's gonna bust through.
Nah.
Oh, okay. That guy's me right now.
Jesus Christ, the sound quality! Wow!
Recorded in an actual closet. Yep, once again, the boys are back in town. These guys are the Shiteno, huh? Somehow I doubt that. Oretachi no boys. Oh, don't mind me. I'm just cowering over here.
I mean, I would probably do the same thing if these guys burst in.
Yeah. Guys, we're trying to put on a Sega CD Monday.
Bando Takuto, 15 歳. 性格は? 無気力、無感動、無表情。そのくせ自分より弱いものに対しては強気に出る。
You're talking about the kid. He's like 15 years old and kind of a nerd, apparently.
Are they calling him like pathetic?
I guess so.
オタクだね。うん。書類を見る限り、こいつで間違いなさそうだ。
Hey everybody, welcome to the show. I'm real glad you came here to watch the stream.
Hey, he is playing Mario. That's why the Sega gods have come to correct him.
They're pissed. They're like, hey, no. You're gonna get your copyright pulled, you know that. Here's a group shot of the... Oh, I love them.
Oh, looks just like
them. Oh my god, I love them. They are perfect.
Well, we do enjoy the niche of games that are based on musical acts. There was, of course, Stolen Song, Revolution X, Seiki Matsu on Famicom.
Oh god, Funky Horror Band?
Yeah.
Okay, info from Electric Boogaloo here. The character designs were by Fujio Akatsuka, who is the creator of Osumatsu-kun. So that's where that Osumatsu-kun looks come from.
They're definitely looking very Osumatsu-kun. Yeah. That makes sense to me. Well, Shiteno have left. And all I am here with is my Sega CD. This is a weird interface, look at this.
It's... I guess that's you looking. Okay, according to the Always Truthful Wikipedia...
Whoa, shit! Oh, fuck, my head!
What the fuck happened? I looked away for 1 second to read a Wikipedia article and you're dying here.
I pushed the wrong button.
Oh, did you push the decapitate yourself button?
Yeah.
Don't do that! Alright, Bakufu Slump was a Japanese rock band active between 1982 and 1999. During the 1980s and 90s, the band was, and this is in quotation marks, hugely popular in Japan.
Why is it in quotation marks?
I don't know. Among their best-known songs was Runner. Could you stop beheading yourself, Danny?
Apparently not.
See, Hektara says it sounds like it was recorded on a toy you buy at Rite Aid.
Yeah, the sound quality is shit, even for Mega CD. Let's go to game. Yeah, play your game. Pretend like nothing happened. That's me.
Mm-hmm.
Was that intentional? Not a good trick to play on me, guys. Not in the shape that my Sega CD is in. Not a very good joke. I'm not laughing.
Oh my god! Oh!
Well, okay.
That is pretty fucking funny.
That is pretty funny. So,
not for us, though. Not for us.
I legit couldn't tell. Legit could not tell. That's the state our Sega CD is in. Well, I tried to eat a game cartridge.
Don't do that.
Wow, it's an adventure game where every option leads to death.
Okay, according to Moby Games, Bakuden Unbalanced Son is a humorous game in which the player controls a nerdy video game playing boy who is one day visited by four strange men who tell him he must venture into a different reality.
Whoa.
The unlikely hero is transported to the prehistoric era where he must set things right with local tribe and dangerous wildlife.
Let's go. Oh, I chose go to sleep.
Are you just falling asleep?
Yeah.
Well, good night, Danny.
This is a weird one. Even for Mega CD Monday. Go back in time to get you a caveman girlfriend. Wouldn't be surprised.
No. Yeah, this does not seem like a good... This does not seem like a popular candidate for fan translation, unfortunately. This is a shame. I'd love to see this.
That's kind of what sucks and is also what's so alluring about the Mega CD library. Like, none of these games are ever going to be translated. No one cares about the Mega CD. And yet, here these games are. Released in some kind of context. That is completely beyond us. Oh, they're hooking me. So the correct choice was to go to sleep.
Yeah, apparently only one of the buttons here actually lets you move forward each time, so...
Is that how the whole game is?
Much like Panic, yeah.
Zone! It's kind of like a deconstructed adventure game now that I think about it. It's like all the options are wrong except for one every time. And really, isn't that like just every adventure game?
Yeah, that is Jajamaro. Isn't Jajamaro getting a new game or some shit?
They just announced a compilation is coming soon, which does include a new game. PS4, Xbox One, and Switch.
Danny, I kind of love this.
This game's amazing.
I don't like the flashing. I do love tripping through time in a helmet.
That is basically a Met.
Get Johnny Turbo to localize the Jajamaro collection.
Arnold, I wouldn't count him out just yet. Dispatch Games is kind of releasing pretty much everything. Well, except for Soul Dam on PS4.
Well, tell them to release this, because I need this in my life.
The Jajamaru collection has got squashed. I mean, not the prototype version, but that game. It's officially better than Bubsy.
That's true, it is.
Yeah, Vort Game Paradise. That is such a Japanese game, and yet they brought it over. These days a lot of stuff gets brought over. So, Jajamaru isn't exactly a long shot, even though it does include a couple of RPGs.
This just kinda goes.
Yeah. Well, we're getting our mission about what to do when we're back in time, I guess.
Defeat a dinosaur.
No, marry the dinosaur.
Oh, sorry, marry the dinosaur. Kill the caveman. And...
Are we playing Marry, Fuck, Kill in the prehistoric age?
Yeah.
Kill caveman, marry dinosaur.
Fuck trilobite. Or woolly mammoth, depending on how you're feeling.
Okay.
I'm sorry.
Are we ready?
Can we move on?
Maybe it's time. We've learned all we can from the great Bakufuden.
ここ原始の村では楽しいことが全くなく、それをみんなで探していた。今日も村の長を中心に楽しいことについての話し合いを行っている。
That's just an Osomatsu-kun character.
I love him. Well,
it's me, the nerd.
I squashed the king with my ass.
Attention, fellow caveman. Ook, ook.
I think you can apologize after you killed him.
Uh-oh. Yeah, this music is what they listened to back in the prehistoric age.
That's pretty good, honestly.
Oh, he's still alive.
Oh, he's got little musical notes on him.
I'm just sitting here letting this unfold.
I'm just glad the Sega CD is playing it, honestly.
Hey, me too, and we only got a few more games to go after this.
The people calling him the confused video game nerd. I love my wife says they've gone and took him back to the past to live the shitty life that sucks ass.
Oh, hey, look at this.
Oh, nice. I want look tributes.
At this. Oh, yeah, now we're talking. They can make pastries?
So I guess they think we're a god?
The gods must be crazy.
Damn.
Yes, Jeeves, bring me your finest Mega CD. No, Mega CD? They haven't been invented yet! No!
It's bullshit.
That's my episode of The Twilight Zone. I have all the time in the world to play the Mega CD! And yet these people don't even have electricity! No, what an ironic twist of fate.
They should get all the meat you want.
I think we've been kicked out.
For what?
For being a nerd.
Oh, that's fair. We are pretty nerdy.
And now our adventure begins.
Back to the imbalance zone!
Best eye-catch sequences in any Mega CD game. That's what this game has.
That's amazing.
These are good. Alright, game. What you got for me now? Okay. I'm gonna head into the forest, where we've been exiled, apparently.
Mm-hmm. We're asking for too many video games.
Get in the zone.
Do you think they had prehistoric auto zones for those, like, prehistoric cars?
Yeah, for those cars that you operate with your feet. Meanwhile, in a different art style.
So AutoZone just sells shoes, I assume.
And stone tires.
Okay, you're right.
Weirdly enough, antifreeze.
Oh, that's Sabertooth Tiger, okay. That's who you're supposed to, you know.
This is long form Panic. If Panic had voices and an overall narrative, well, it had voices, but you know. Oh no, the saber-toothed tiger's gonna eat me.
They're gonna kick your ass,
Dan. He's just waiting down there. Is that like a Japanese rim shot just now?
I assume so.
Okay, well, we've ended up in yet another situation. Well,
everything about this is great.
All right, so your choices are Wink, Kamaeru, whatever that means. We can use our Keitai Denwa, which is our cell phone, and something else. I'm gonna wink. Maybe we can seduce him.
Hey, see?
I think it's working.
Oh, he doesn't want me? Wow, someone's fucking picky. Well, he lost his head this time, at least.
Hmm. Okay.
Oh, that worked. Shit.
Lucky first choice.
You just had to kiss the tiger.
Mm-hmm. Oh, now we don't get the gag sequences, but whatever. All right, that's our one interaction for the next 30 minutes.
Ah, shit, he's back.
Wasn't fooled. Gotta run.
Kiss him again! Keep kissing him!
Do they have a different artist do each one of these scenes?
I mean, it looks like the same artist, it's just different art styles.
And yeah.
I do like the hatching there for the shading.
Better than dithering.
Mm-hmm.
Alright, new interaction point. So, we got Tojiru, whatever that means. Nakuru, which means to punch it. Manto. Naru, something else. Let's do whatever this is. Ah. Oh.
Nice.
Classic Bugs Bunny shit.
Man, you're doing good.
Yeah, I just gotta think like a cartoon.
Mm-hmm.
Let's turn into a Bakuten speedrun.
GDQ, call us.
Mm-hmm. Oh, if we had GDQ backing, we could have, like, someone live translate.
Oh, that'd be wonderful.
Running. Maybe we're trying to pass a test by the caveman. Just throwing us out there with the saber-toothed tigers.
Cool.
Oh no!
You and your new tiger husband are in the... I guess they're not technically your husband yet. You know, you can make that happen.
I just gotta find the right option.
Mm-hmm.
Okay, we gotta look for Kekkon Suru. Let's punch him.
Seems mean. Is he refusing to punch him?
Maybe.
Oh, they're just both pissed now.
Hurt my fist punching the saber-toothed tiger.
Don't punch a saber-toothed tiger. Well, now you're dead, Danny. You're fucking dead. You caused the cave-in, and you and your potential tiger husband are dead.
This isn't going so well. Oh.
Okay, not that. Don't punch a tiger. Kiss.
Yes. Can't climb out of here. Hey, help us! Oh no, it's gonna cave in again.
Okay, so don't holler. Don't punch.
Let's go with question mark.
Okay.
I like the sound of that.
Maybe that's the kiss option. See, because when you kiss the tiger, they're gonna be so happy they're gonna, like, float on air, and then you can just grab onto their legs as they float out.
Oh, now you're thinking like a toon.
Mm-hmm.
That's how it works here in Toontown.
Bugs Bunny strats.
Oshiri Pin Pin. Well, Oshiri means butt. There it is. I'm not sure how this is supposed to help us. Oh, God! Oh, it caused an explosive fart, which got us out of here.
Oh, my God!
That's some galaxy brain shit right there. That was the solution.
Oh my god. Oh my god. Well, we're banned from Twitch, which is cool.
I guess so. Look, you're still chasing me? I just got us out of there.
I was gonna say, you saved this fucker's life, and he still hates you.
I showed you my ass. We share a bond now. You know what my ass looks like.
Cool vine.
I'm liking this. I think we should finish off today's stream with this game.
I think so too.
I'm just gonna play a few more minutes before we call it, but this was a surprise hit. I like where this is going. It's a very simplified adventure game where even if you don't know the language, you can still make progress.
Yeah, like you can kind of clutch your way through.
And the humor here is universal. I mean, who hasn't shown their ass to a saber-toothed tiger?
And the tiger bit it, and then they just escaped a massive hole that they fell in.
Oh no, he fell into a tar pit or something.
Save him! Save him!
I guess we should save him. Go with the question marks.
This tiger hates when you're horny at him. It is like his least favorite thing.
And this is the best game being streamed on Twitch right now.
Wow, you got buff!
People who aren't watching this are missing out.
Mm-hmm. Thank you, Tepid Snake. They resubscribed 19 months. And they say, shown up right at the end to hear who hasn't shown their ass to a saber-toothed tiger. And yep, seems on brand. Yeah, this is...
it's well, relatable.
Well, he died.
And thank you.
He died from sexy lake dancing, so try something else.
Yeah, that wasn't the solution.
Don't die this time, Danny. I know.
This one. Ishii. Yeah, I'm gonna throw a rock.
No! Don't kill him!
Not sure what that was supposed to do.
I think you were trying to kill them.
Oh, maybe.
Oh, and well. There goes your head once more. Cool, your eyeball fell out.
A lot of decapitations in this game.
There's so much decapitation in this game! Like a Twitter reply thread.
Oh, he threw one of his fangs at us.
That makes sense.
All we've done is make him mad. Here it goes again.
And there goes your head. Have you tried the hand option yet?
Let's try that.
Okay. Maybe you have to give him a hand.
Let's give the boy a hand. Hey!
You did it. I hope the cat still tries to kill you.
You were right, we just had to lend him a hand.
Mm-hmm.
Oh, we gotta be friends now.
Great music?
It is music.
I think he really does want to be our boyfriend.
Good. We're telling him about how we're from a different time.
We just weren't made for these times, man.
Alright, bring the saber-toothed tiger back to the village. Have it eat everyone. And then we take over. It does sound like a tiger LCD game.
Oh my god, it does.
Compose their albums on a GameCon. The worst album ever.
Well, yeah, it's like in Time Gal, you can't kill the cavemen because you're gonna disappear.
Oh, yeah.
You can't kill your ancestors.
Stupid change in history. Is that the end of the chapter? What an interesting game. It's kind of only nominally an adventure game. It's more like you just pick options from a menu till you pick the right one.
Uzi, you missed us showing our ass to a saber-toothed tiger and it getting eaten.
A thing that actually happened.
Yeah.
This game's neat. I kind of like this one.
I like this a lot.
Sure, I don't understand, but I get the basics. Running away from a saber-toothed tiger.
Mm-hmm.
Picking him up from a swamp.
Mm-hmm. Definitely get that swamp stuff. Hey, you escaped the forest.
I realize what this is. This is a level-based adventure game.
That's kind of...
Okay. Come on.
Okay.
So I tell you what, I think we'll get to the next choice pathway, and once we finish that one, we'll call it.
Sounds good.
This game has its hooks in me, though.
Mm-hmm. Yeah, I wish Spectrum was acting nicer, because I'd love to keep playing this.
I mean, the dropped frames work really well with the limited animation. Yosemite-kun creator threw an ashtray at anyone over this. I don't know. I'd be happier with this than I was with Osomatsu-kun on Mega Drive.
Yeah, that was not so good.
Maybe this is kind of like an apology to that guy.
This game is at least interesting, which is nothing they could say about a lot of games.
It's not a first-person dungeon crawler. Not an F1 game.
Mm-hmm.
I'm a horse now.
Cool. When'd that happen?
Just now.
Okay, cool.
Clop, 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 clop.
Honey, I married a horse!
Yeah, the ashtray thing is a thing that happened once the creators saw just how bad the Mega Drive Osomatsu-kun game was.
Oh, that's amazing.
Like a big heavy one, too. Shrine maidens. Here in prehistory.
Eh.
Probably normal.
History's a flat circle anyway.
Genshi no mura de って頼まれまして、楽しいことってのを探してるんですが、何かご存知ですか？
答えましょう。楽しいことばかりや
って。That one's got a weird mouth.
I love Toad Woman.
苦しいことを感じることができなくなります。
Ribbit.
苦しいこと。
She's perfect.
楽しいことばかりやっていると、楽しいことを喜ぶことができなくなってしまいます。
Oh, are these Toho's?
Yeah, this is Reimu.
Mm-hmm.
And next to her is...
Toad Woman.
This Toad Woman, the other famous Toho.
Oh, I love Toad Woman.
で、僕は一体どうすれば…
This looks like a Simpsons background character. Kind of uncanny, actually.
Like from season one or two.
Yes.
Really, the only bad thing about this game is the sound quality. They could have bumped it up.
Yeah, it's kind of
fits in with the sketchy art style. Maybe it was intentional. Who can tell? Alright, next puzzle. Or was that a whole chapter? Okay.
Well, cool.
Congrats, everyone. We solved another chapter. What could possibly be after this? What could possibly go wrong?
I'm assuming more cavemen, but...
I still can't believe this game pulled a fake Sega CD crashing screen on me.
That was hilarious!
Still actually a little pissed off about that. Like, hey, Danny, here's a little jab in the eye just for you. No one else playing this game throughout history, just for you.
Just for you, Danny. Alright, are we good?
We may be good. Alright, so, well, this guy's adventures will continue in prehistory as he tries to get back to the modern era and back to his Mega CD. We are lucky to live in a time where we are not in prehistory. In fact, we are free to use the Mega CD however we choose. I want to see what the next scene is.
Okay.
Give this like 30 more seconds.
Okay, I'm just really hungry.
I am too. We gotta eat lunch here.
We have roast pork, baby.
Something about the mama zone.
Roast pork zone.
I assume this game goes on a while. I wonder if there's a long play out there. Maybe so. Thank you for the clip. Okay, we gotta find out what's in the egg. You're curious, right?
I am. I won't lie.
It's in the egg.
Yeah, the band hasn't really been in the game since the intro.
No, not at all. Alright, here's our last chance. What are we gonna do?
Alright, what do these say?
Taberu, which is eat.
Don't.
This is Kansatsu Suru. Knock on it. Scott, oh, this one's bleeped out.
Danny?
I don't even know what I'm choosing.
What are you doing?
This is dangerous.
What are you doing?
Oh, okay, I see. It's not like lewd, it's just like...
Goodbye.
I think that was supposed to be a Dragon Ball Z reference.
Ah, okay. I see. You're examining its power level. Like, yeah. Okay.
Not yet. I gotta solve the thing.
Okay.
I gotta see what's in the egg.
Okay, let's see what's in the egg.
Let's knock on the egg. Hey, who's there? Open up. Egg police. It knocked back.
That's good.
It's that. That's what it is.
Danny, what the fuck is that?
I don't know. Ostrich? I'm gonna go with ostrich. Yeah, it's an ostrich. We figured it out. The puzzle is solved. And with that, I think we'll end today's stream. Well, that was a very bizarre trip into the unbalanced zone, and wow, yeah, I'd say it was unbalanced, for sure. Very, very easy way of describing what that was. What the fuck was that, Alex?
I don't fucking know. That was amazing. Also, everyone in chat is like, we're Bird Mom now.
Oh, good. Our quest is over. We have become Bird Mom. Good. Good.
Creator of birds.
I feel good with that ending.
Mm-hmm.
Well, that concludes another successful edition of Mega CD Monday. We now have about 5 or 6 games to cover until we've covered every single Japanese Mega CD release. So if all goes well next week, we should be finishing off that lineup.
Hooray.
Then we'll move on to bigger and better things, hooking up a new Sega CD. It's all coming up. It's all coming up, Retro Pals. Finally.
I'm excited to see what's in that box. I hope it's not monsters. Please, Ultimo, don't send us monsters.
Well, if you never hear from us again, then yeah, we were sent monsters. But sweet. Odds are good. It's probably some good stuff. We shall see. So, we'll be back on Wednesday at 7 p.m. Central with what our patrons voted to see and what they wanted to see in the battle between dogs versus cats. It's cats.
It's cats always won. Cats.
So Wednesday, tune in for a very special edition of Retro Pals Showcase Wednesdays featuring cat games.
Ooh.
Games with kitties. I have some games in mind. Not quite sure if I want to spoil it just yet, but I think you'll enjoy it. Especially if you like cats.
Good. Well, I love cats. You know me.
Alex, wrap us up. I'll look for a host.
If you want to vote on what we play every Wednesday and you have and get the choice to vote between cats and dogs or whatever we have, lined up for our Wednesday stream, do support us on Patreon. That's at patreon.com/retropals. Also, if you join our Patreon now, you get the first look at the latest episode of Nintendo 64 Chronicles.
I completely forgot about that.
Yeah, you haven't promoted it.
Today,
we
released an early patron preview of N64 Chronicles featuring Pilot Wing 64. We do a deep dive into the history of the series, how it was actually kind of a really rough development for Nintendo, and how they needed to take different and drastic measures to make sure a sequel came out on N64. So check that out if you're a patron, and if not, well, just wait for it.
Yeah, or you know, join. Think about it.
Join us.
And when it is available, it will be ready. It will be on YouTube at youtube.com/retropals. So if you want to see it when it comes out, follow us there. Give us a subscribe. Smash that bell.
Smash the bell.
Fucking show the like button your ass so that it bites you.
Yeah, that's the solution.
All
right, so we got a couple options here. We got... Let's see, Aquas is playing Apedia on the Amiga, so if you want to see Amiga games, head over to Aquas' channel. However, I'm going to host someone we haven't hosted yet, and someone who just got into streaming, and his stream is actually really super good, and you should say hi. This is a dude named Dino Please over on Twitter. He posts a lot of weird combo videos for fighting games that end in bizarre glitches, and now he's doing streaming. And from what I've seen, I've watched him a couple times now. It's good stuff. He's playing Beyond Oasis, possibly some other Genesis stuff. So enjoy that. We'll see you on Wednesday, and thanks for watching.
See ya, folks.